She is one of the most famous symbols of the modern age, and today is her birthday. This is the 100th anniversary of the date on which the spirit of ecstasy was first registered as one of the world's most famous trademarks, a significant milestone in Rolls-Royce's illustrious 107-year history.
We are celebrating 100 years birthday, or the centenary of that marvelous mascot, the most well-known mascot in automotive industry. It's the spirit of ecstasy. It shows a lot about the commitment, the elegance, the precision, the refinement which we carry in our brand, and it is for us, you can say, an inbuilt promise in the brand, this spirit of ecstasy. So this is the best in terms of motoring which you can buy, and this is, let's say, promised by that fabulous lady on the bonnet of our cars.
To mark this milestone for the brand, 100 modern and vintage Rolls-Royce cars took to the streets of central London today. The cars gathered at Hyde Park Corner, where members of the Rolls-Royce Enthusiast Club, Rolls-Royce staff and members of the public gathered to admire this priceless collection of motor vehicles.
We will see probably a lot more events to come over the year, and what we've also planned to do is to release a special series of centenary cars, which are 100 Phantoms, specially purpose-built and equipped for celebrating the centenary of the spirit of ecstasy.
The procession headed out on a drive to Sion House, the home of the Duke of Northumberland, by way of Westminster Bridge and the Houses of Parliament, turning heads and bringing a touch of glamour to a cold winter's day. She may have been celebrating her centenary, but the spirit of ecstasy is a lady who still draws admiring glances wherever she goes.
Front-to-rear collisions are the most common everyday crashes. They tie up traffic, they cause expensive damage to vehicles, and they can result in minor injuries like neck whiplash and back sprain. Automakers can design vehicles to protect people in crashes and to protect the vehicles themselves from costly damage in those crashes. The Highway Loss Data Institute is evaluating some of the latest crash avoidance technology by looking at insurance claims to see if the vehicles with the systems are getting into fewer crashes. The first of the new systems that we studied is Volvo's City Safety. It's standard equipment on the Volvo XC60 SUV, which is the vehicle we looked at in this study. We expect this kind of technology to become more commonplace on vehicles in the future. Our results show that city safety is working, is preventing crashes. The frequency of property damage liability claims was more than 25% lower for the Volvo XC60 than for other mid-sized luxury SUVs. Property damage liability claims are the insurance coverage that pays for damage to vehicles caused by an at-fault driver. And more than one in four of those crashes appear to have been eliminated. Here's how city safety works. There's an infrared laser sensor built into the windshield here that monitors the roadway in front of the vehicle out about 18 feet. It does this constantly, day and night, and even if the driver's attention wanders. If the traffic in front of you suddenly stops and your speed is less than 9 miles an hour, which is common in stop-and-go traffic, then city safety can actually prevent the crash. If your speed's a little faster, say up to 18 or 19 miles an hour, city safety will still activate the automatic brakes and reduce the severity of the collision. I'm in commuter traffic, and the car ahead of me suddenly stops. City safety senses the imminent collision and automatically kicks in to try to prevent it and apply the brakes. If I'm distracted because maybe I'm talking to my passenger and I don't hit the brakes myself quickly enough, then city safety senses that the collision is about to happen, applies the brakes automatically, tries to avoid the collision altogether, but at least reduce the severity of the collision that occurs. Crash avoidance technology offers a lot of promise for highway safety, and we're doing more research to see if other systems, like Volvo City Safety, live up to their billing in the real world.
Looking for a new car or truck? TheAutoChannel.com has the most complete and up-to-date pricing, vehicle specifications, and reviews.
We'll be right back.
Looking for a new car or truck? TheAutoChannel.com has the most complete and up-to-date pricing, vehicle specifications, and reviews.
Thank you. You know, you can search the AutoChannel.com's new car buyer's guide to quickly and easily find specs, prices, multi-car comparison, and the latest news about every new passenger car and truck sold in North America. TheAutoChannel.com, there's nothing else like it.
Direct from Detroit, Motor City, USA. The Auto Channel presents exclusive press pass coverage of the North American International Auto Show.
Coming to Tesla's booth this afternoon. We're very excited to be here. 2010 was definitely a watershed year for Tesla Motors. We had the opportunity to obviously go public. We cemented and grew our great relationships that we have with Daimler, with Toyota, with Panasonic. We started programs such as the A-Class and the Smart program with Daimler. We started the Toyota RAV4 EV program. And of course, we purchased our production facility, the future home of the Model S in Fremont, California, a half hour away from our headquarters in Palo Alto. 2011, I think, will continue on that growth. I think that if people would have said that we were going to be capable to build a car, we were going to have the idea to build a car, an electric car that would compete with the best cars in the world, that people would actually desire and want to consider purchasing in lieu of a traditional combustion engine, a lot of people would have said that we were crazy, that we were too small to do this, that we didn't have the experience to do this. And yet here we are in 2011, and of course the vehicle I'm talking about is the Tesla Roadster. The Tesla Roadster that we introduced 2 years ago to the marketplace, I think, showed that electric cars can not only be efficient as we had presumed, but they can be desirable cars. They can compete with the best cars in the world. And the Tesla Roadster, last year, right here in Detroit, we displayed VIN 1000. On Earth Day in April, we announced that we had traveled, the Tesla Roadsters had driven 4 million miles. We stand here today and we have over 1,500 Roadsters on the road in over 30 countries around the world. They've driven 8.5 million miles. We're on our way to 10 million electric miles. Everything we have learned from the Tesla Roadster, we are using to build our next generation vehicle, the Model S. A lot of people know about Tesla's commitment to design, the fact that we believe we can build a beautiful car that can also be a very economical car. A lot of people understand and know and have accepted that Tesla has the most advanced power electronics, the most advanced powertrain and battery technology in the world. What a lot of people don't know and don't realize is that we have built a phenomenal automotive engineering team that is building what I think is going to be the premier sedan when it comes out in 2012. I want to introduce Peter Rawlinson, who's been with Tesla Motors for over 2 years now. He is the man responsible for selecting, I think, the best team in the world that has built this car. And the process of today is to really show the automotive engineering that goes into the Model S. Peter?
Thank you so much, Ricardo. Well, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome. Thank you so much for joining us. As Ricardo has said, I think Tesla is already renowned for its prowess in powertrain technology. Its battery packs are very efficient, very energy dense. It's a leader in power electronics and electric drive systems. And also, I believe Tesla is enjoying a burgeoning reputation for its design studio. But today, our focus is upon vehicle engineering. We seek to showcase vehicle engineering's capability, the in-house capability that Tesla has acquired. One of the really great enticements for me with joining the company 2 years ago, the inspiration, was to build up a really talented engineering team and produce some cutting-edge engineering. So I think it's entirely appropriate today that instead of showing you a show car, we actually show you an engineering exhibit showing the level of engineering and technology that underpins the Model S at its alpha prototype stage. Please. So we've really taken a clean sheet approach to what the design of electric cars should be. Maybe I should say a blank computer screen approach. We've looked at the best layout, the best architecture, and we've really taken a fresh-eyed look at what advantages electrification of a vehicle can hold. We've looked and discovered advances in safety, advances in aerodynamics, advances in stability, in ride and handling, even in ride quality and rigidity and integrity of the vehicle. And we've done all this by creating this package, and I'll just highlight some of the key elements before I go in a little bit more detail. Here, dominating the exhibit is the aluminum-intensive Model S body structure. It's not just a body structure, though, for Model S. It also embodies the brand new in-house Tesla-designed platform, which will serve a family of future derivative vehicles which will spawn off this. Underneath here, you can see the very slimline battery pack, which is detachable from underneath the floor. It's an expensive pack. It's been beautifully packaged. It's been reduced in height to the absolute minimum to give the optimum space available to the inside of the car. Also, we have the Tesla-designed state-of-the-art suspension systems. We have a virtual axis double wishbone front suspension, aluminum-intensive, a modular construction so that it readily suits mass manufacture. And if I can just draw your attention to the rear, we have a module here which comprises a subframe, an aluminum-intensive subframe, onto which mounts a brand new Tesla-designed in-house multi-link rear suspension system, and also accommodates the electric motor, the gearbox, and the power electronics, all in one very neat and exquisitely packaged module. So first, let me take you through the architecture of the body structure and the platform. We've used a combination of different process technologies to make the not just the lightest and most efficient structure, but the safest. And we combine the use of castings with aluminum extrusions and stampings. We're also using an extensive spot welding system, which is very innovative for an aluminum-intensive architecture. Now, why should we choose aluminum? It's because weight-saving benefits are so important. Aerodynamics, weight saving, these are the gifts to range for an electric vehicle. So although we've assiduously pursued weight saving, it's been at absolutely no expense to safety. In fact, safety is a cornerstone of the Tesla philosophy. Underneath the car, as I alluded to, there is a battery pack which contains just over 7,000 cells. It's effectively the next natural evolution of the proven battery technology that has been out there on the Tesla Roadster. And as Ricardo has said, we've now accrued 8.5 million miles with that vehicle. So this is the next natural evolution of that technology, embodying a range of subtle improvements, but the most notable is how slimline we've managed to create that pack. But the story doesn't end there. That pack does far more than just contain the batteries. We use that as a structural element in its own right. And when it's married to the unibody, there is a multiplier effect in terms of the structural integrity. The two structures augment one another. And this is for the benefit of the vibration of the car, which helps in ride quality and also in terms of ride and handling, but it also augments the safety cell, the safety cage, which is central to this vehicle architecture, the all-important safety cell which protects occupants in an accident. We have a range of innovations in the battery pack which bridge out across the car to stiffen the side of the car in the event of a side impact. We have even a feature where we believe that the steering sensitivity will be enhanced through the presence of the battery pack offering such exceptional stiffness to the mounting system of the steering rack. Ride and handling is a vital attribute which we take very seriously. And this has got just the great basis for a very fine handling car. With the mass of the battery low down, the car has an extraordinarily low center of gravity, which helps stability and control and safety, but moreover appeals to the discerning driver. And that's what the Tesla Model S is all about. Also, because the center of gravity is very low, the car doesn't want to roll in corners so much. So we can have very light duty sway bars. And this improves the ride quality of the vehicle, improves the overall noise and vibration. And this is so important for an electric vehicle. So turning our attention to the front suspension, it's all new, Tesla designed in-house, and it's been designed hand in glove with the platform. It's not a carryover from any other vehicle. It's designed bespoke for this Tesla platform, and the two work together. They're very neatly packaged together using the minimal amount of space. And space is a recurrent theme, the use of space in this vehicle. It's enabled us to achieve over 30 cubic feet of luggage space, because we don't just have extraordinary luggage space at the rear, we have a frontal trunk area, volume, where a gasoline motor would normally be positioned. So this makes Model S an eminently practical proposition for the family. Turning attention to the rear, the rear suspension module and subframe and electric motor and power electronics are very neatly packaged. And integral with that is this air suspension system, which Model S is equipped with. This car has air. I think it's also very important that I point out, what you see here is not some fantasy, it's not some show car. It's not something that's been created specifically for a motor show. This is genuinely one of our alpha fleet, which we've taken out of the fleet. Sure, we've cosmetically enhanced it a little bit for show purposes, but it is a genuine, bona fide representation of a Model S at alpha phase. And I would invite you to take a closer look in due course and enjoy and understand some of the engineering thought that has gone into this. I'm also accompanied by key members of my vehicle engineering team. I have a very illustrious team at Tesla, and they will be very happy, more than happy, to answer any questions that you may wish to field, including myself. Thank you.
The idea is finally to bring Lotus back to his legitimate place at the same level of Porsche, Ferrari, for example. In terms of design, in terms of exclusivity, in terms of performance.
The new Esprit is a rebirth of an icon, the new Esprit. It will be a powerful sports car machine
that has the capacity to really move emotion.
It's a prestigious sports car. It will be an ultra-performing sports car.
It is also the most glamorous. Everybody remember the Esprit in the James Bond movie. This car needed the shape, the personality that was unique, that could not look like anything else that already exists on the market. very low, wide, and has all the cabin very forward.
It's targeting a group who drive a sports car because they are successful, because they can afford a sports car at this level with the performance and the build quality.
Very muscular and a unique view from the rear, which says instantly what the car is capable of.
It certainly puts Lotus on the map again, and I think it hopefully puts Lotus to where it was 20 years ago.
It is a symbol of sportivity, exclusivity for Lotus.
Esprit is back. I'm 100% convinced that this car will fight against the big sports cars today.
Direct from Switzerland, the Auto Channel presents exclusive press pass coverage of the Geneva Motor Show.
The basis that gives us reason to believe that we will have 20 to 25 customers a year is that we go, like Hispano-Suiza in former times, we go to the real values of that brand. The real values like performance, quality, and prestige. This is what emotions wake up. And we will have these emotions in this car. So all you have to know about technology is that the body of this car is aluminum space frame with magnesium and carbon fiber. We have a 10-cylinder engine that is supercharged by two electric-driven chargers with an output of 750 horsepower, coming to the fact that with a weight of 1,590 kilograms, we have a super performance, but still don't go racing.
I'm really glad to see you here and very happy to be here today. We had a very busy year at Koenigsegg, both on the market side and of course on the development side. We actually had our record year with a really good turnover and a good margin, a profitable margin. And this year we're celebrating 15 years of creating supercars. And well, to celebrate these 15 years of evolutionary supercar making, we're very happy here today to present our new supercar, the Agera. It's of course an evolutionary stance, like all Koenigsegg products. Still, it's a very new car. It has over 1,000 new components. Some of them are visible on the outside, like a wider front end with a new a look, and some aerodynamic tweaks, increased louvers. It actually has around 300 kilos of downforce at 250 kilometers per hour. We have new wing mirrors, a larger Venturi tunnel at the rear to balance out the extra downforce we achieve in the front. The car is developed to be more track focused than our previous cars, so it comes standard with a 4-point safety belt. We also have in the interior a new instrument cluster, which is fully adaptable and programmable with a lot of new features. This one is specially adopted for the Brazilian market, meaning it's also is capable of flex fueling all the way up to E100 fuel. And that was an interesting challenge because it's quite corrosive, as in Brazil they have some water in the fuel as well. And we're very proud to enter the Brazilian market with this car, and again shows our flexibility to adapt to different circumstances. So I hope you really enjoy the Geneva show this year. Thank you very much.
Thanks for watching the Auto Channel. For more great coverage of all major motor events, visit theautochannel.com, the internet's most complete and comprehensive automotive resource.